right, so today we want to focus on multiplying fractions times a fraction times a fraction and a fraction times a whole number. This first example is given here, and I want to show you how that you would show a model to represent what this fraction would be. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a rectangle, and I will model the second number first, okay, 4/5. So I'm going to divide this box into fifths. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 equal sections. Okay, and then I want to show that I'm shading in 4 of the fifths. So I'm going to lightly shade 4/5. Okay, and then the second number, which is actually the second part of the model, is going to be your first number, which is 2/3. And I'm actually showing 2/3 of 4/5. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to look at the denominator, 3, and I want to separate this into 3 equal sections. So 1, 2, and 3 equal parts. And now I'm going to shade in 2 of the thirds. And I'm going to go this way and show how I can go all the way across and shade in 2 of the thirds. Now this is the interesting part, and I think it's kind of fun. This is where you circle the part that is overlapped by both colors. Okay? And this is actually the part where you are counting your double overlap. This is going to be your numerator. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay? And then your total amount of squares, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, is your denominator. 8/15 is your correct way to model showing 2/3 of 4/5. Now, of course, now the easy way to do this, if you didn't draw a model, was would just be to multiply straight across. 2 times 4 is 8, and 3 times 5 is 15, okay? But I want you also to see this is how you could model this. Now, let's try another example. Okay, so here's another example. 1/3 of 3/4, 1/3 times 3/4 means the same thing. So to model this, I'll draw a rectangle, and I'm going to model this second number first, 3/4. So let me divide my rectangle into 4 equal sections and shade in 3 of them. 1, 2, and 3. Okay, and now I'll come back to the first number, 1/3, and I want to separate this into thirds. 1, 2, 3 equal parts, and shade in only 1 of the thirds. Okay, now let's circle the part that is overlapped with both colors. And that would be just these 3 parts right here. 1, 2, 3. 3 are overlapped. And how many are there total? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Now you can easily see that this is 1 times 3 is 3 and 3 times 4 is 12, 3/12. But this would be your way that you could model it. All right, let's look at a different type of problem. Okay, so now we have a fraction times a whole number. And you remember from previous understanding, if we were just multiplying this straight across, you'd put a 1 underneath and you would just multiply straight across. But let me show you how to do a model, okay? So we're starting with this second number and it's whole number 6. So we know that we need 6 boxes, okay? Okay, so So here is six boxes, and we want to separate these boxes into now thirds, because we're going to shade in two of the thirds on each of the boxes. So let's separate these into thirds. All right. And now let's fill in two of the thirds on each of the six boxes. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, and two. Now, what is the meaning of this? This is six, two-thirds times six. So let's count and see how many actual thirds we have shaded in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So here are 12 thirds, okay? What's the meaning of 12 thirds? Well, 12 thirds means 12 divided by 3, right? So the actual meaning of this is the whole number 4. Let's do it up here now. Let's see if we can just multiply and get the same answer. Put a 1 underneath the 6. 2 times 6 is 12. 3 times 1 is 3. And we have the same answer. You can see 12 divided by 3 is your whole number 4. All right?